today I just got a notification email from PixInsight and they released a new gradient correction tool with a new PixInsight version 1.8.9.2. Is this the best gradient correction tool? Is better than Graxpert? We'll make this comparison and see who's the new king on gradient removal. To be able to use the new gradient correction tool, you first need to download the new PixInsight version and you need to go on the download page. We'll show you in a moment. From here, you'll download the version that you need for your operating system. Here I downloaded the Windows version. Once you download it, you'll install it and then open PixInsight. Once you open PixInsight, you'll also have to go here, Resources, Updates, check for updates, and then close PixInsight, install the new updates, and then you'll be able to get back the scripts, like Blood Exterminator, Noise Exterminator, and Star Exterminator. Also, you'll have access to this gradient correction that you'll find here in File, and you'll go Process Explorer, and you'll search here at All Processes, and you'll be able to find it here. It's called Gradient Correction. Then you can drag it and place it here as a new process and rename it. And I will begin on the images that also the new Gradient Correction tool and Graxpert had problems. These images were especially close-up galaxies, like mosaics. And here we have one with Andromeda Galaxy. Here I used also the Structure Protection and Generate Protection Mask and Automatic Convergence for the best results. And it created more masks here, you can see. And it used the last one. And on galaxies, I think having this option on it will help. On most of the situations, you can go with the default settings without using the automatic convergence. So this was the result with gradient correction in this huge mosaic at 1650 millimeters focal length, about 11 panels. It did not perform good. In these situations, I advise to use it on individual panels, remove the gradients and then combine them. And check also the results with Graxpert. Very bad result on this. And I would suggest not use an image like this to process it further. Okay, now let's see a smaller panel. Here was used Graxpert. And you see here we lost a lot of features and details in the Galaxy arms. And here we have the one with gradient correction tool. And the result with the new gradient correction tool is much better. Not quite perfect. It still removed a little bit of light here, but is much better compared with Graxpert. So if we go back here and check the results, you see here what a dark gradient we have on the right. And now much better result. But we do have a big improvement compared with Graxpert. Now Messier 81 and 82. Here I've tested also the new gradient correction tool and Graxpert. You can see both remove the gradients well. There's very small differences. Actually, I do not see any differences here. The image before looked like this. Now we saw how these two gradient removal tools worked on galaxies, and let's move to nebulas. And here we have IC405, the Flaming Star Nebula and the Tadpoles Nebula, the results with Graxpert. Let's see before and now. We can see a visible improvement. However, here on the left, it's a little bit darker, and also on the bottom right. Here we have the image with the gradient correction tool. We can see it removed the gradients better, and we don't have any parts here darker on the corners, and also the nebula dust is visible in these regions also. Using the gradient correction tool, I observed you need to actually reset the auto stretch to get the final look, and this is after I resetted it, and let's compare with the GradExpert image. Similar results, however, I'll say gradient correction tool did a better job. Now let's move to the others. Here was a very difficult image. This is a stack of H-alpha, oxygen-3 and luminance combined together. And let's look how the image is without the gradient correction tool. And it will look like this. In this situation, I think it's best to use the gradient correction tool on each image stack and combine after, so you'll get a better result. I was able to remove these nasty gradients. It's a big improvement compared with the auto background extraction, dynamic background extraction, and also GradExpert. Now, let's see the results with GradExpert. It did not protect the nebula features, and we got a very bad image. So this is another example when the AI from GradExpert that was trained to remove the gradients won't handle every situation. Comparing gradient correction tool with the default settings did a better job than GradExpert. I do want to show you also here starless processed, and after using the gradient correction tool, I've got this. However, it's best, as I mentioned, to do these corrections before on the individual stacks in situations like this. Now let's see here H-alpha image. Before the gradient correction tool, it looks like this, and now it's corrected. And with GradExpert, we managed to get this, another bad result. Now let's take a look on the Witch-Head Nebula. This target is very low from my location. For all the images besides Andromeda, I use the wide field refractors, 360 millimeters with my NewTubeTech camera, the 26,000 KMA with IMX571 sensor. Large resolution of 26 megapixels. And I also used another camera with the same sensor but color for some of the images. Okay, now let's use the gradient correction tool here, the default settings on the Witch-Head Nebula. Okay, so with this stretch, it looks very good. It removed all the gradients. Let's reset the stretch now. In this situation, GradExpert with auto settings did a little bit better. This is the only image until now where GradExpert managed to get a better result. And now let's check also here. Messier 78, this was color calibrated. This is the image with the gradient. This is the image that I've used with the gradient correction. And this is the image with GradExpert. So you can see GradExpert also changed the color balance. And this was the one with the gradient correction tool that kept the color balance. I also want to mention that GradExpert works much slower in PixInsight, the plugin, than the gradient correction tool. After doing all these tests, I believe the new gradient correction tool is much better than GradExpert, at least the current version. It might improve in the future, but currently I think this is the best tool that you can use in PixInsight, at least the best tool I've ever tested. Well, I'm very happy that we have this new tool that will help us process our astrophotography better, remove the gradients better, and have better images. Don't forget to check also the channel membership, because I'll share my astrophotography there. And if you become a member, you'll be able to get access to good quality astrophotography images captured here in Portal 4 Sky. I hope I'll see you in the next video, and until next time, clear sky.